Behind this is a warning that you need to go in and set up your simplicity options to be able to completely use all the functionality that the Web Space plugin provides. It will drop you through and let you sign in just as you would with any other Web Space session from any browser, but we want the full experience. So I'm going to show you how to do that. So we'll come onto the Simplicity Web Space machine, and we'll open up the Simplicity options on your machine, on your Simplicity machine, and we're going to open it as administrator. And you'll see in the Web Space tab we have some new options. The first is to auto start or start the Web Space Session Manager. This is a new service installed in 11.1 of Simplicity that allows a communication path between Operations Hub and your Web Space and Simplicity screens. So this is done in a very secure way. So to set this up to work properly, you'll need to set up the credentials so that you don't have to log in from the Operations Hub page. So I'm going to put my Windows credentials in here and test to make sure that they are successful. Next, I'll need to go retrieve the name and the port for my Operations Hub server UAA connection. So this Operations Hub is running under port 444 in my case, and we're going to put the name of the UAA server, which is running and installed with Operations Hub, into this URL and test to make sure that that's successful. Next, I can view the certificate to make sure it's a valid certificate from the UAA server. I'll trust it, and then I'll generate a UAA client that this session service can talk to. So by default, and you don't need to change the admin, just go to the secret, and here you'll type in the secret that you used when you installed Operations Hub. During the install of Operations Hub, it asks you for a client secret, and you need to use that same secret here, and you can see that it's generated. Finally, you'll need to set up a username. We'll just call it admin and give it a password. This is used to secure the communication between SimView and this session manager that talks back to Operations Hub. If you were on a dependent server, you would specify the Rally server location and the credentials that you set in this tab on the Relay server. So on that separate dependent server, you would put in those credentials here, test to make sure they're right, and you would actually be able to have a secure connection between the dependent, Relay, and then Operations Hub servers. Now that you've done that setup and you can see that it's all green and successful, you hit OK on the options, and it will actually restart the necessary services for those configuration settings to come into play.